Chrissy? Or Tall Chrissy? Or what type of Chrissy is that? Except Chrissy.
News making the headlines.
Black Maria is to carry criminals, tribal looters that are in government today.
Sometimes it gets confrontational.
Slap you in the face.
Kill me, don't put words into my mouth.
Whatever it is that will bring our military to disrepute. I said, oh, hell
on
me.
Cold Digest.
I want to know why I should be believing them.
Every weekday, we bring all of these together and take them to the court of public opinion.
Everybody have your right in Nigeria.
Where you are the judge.
Good to have you join us. The program is Cold Digest Extra on Court TV News. And so we've come to another segment, yes. We're looking at relationship matters, things we do for love. And of course, you know, they say, aside from money making the world go round, love and relationship are also very key things that makes the world go round. Because if a man or woman is not happy relationship-wise, you know, it actually limits such person from thinking better or improving himself. You know, some emotional things that happen could actually be very destabilizing. And so with the rise of so many relationship issues we have in the country now, you know, some would say because of the economy, because there's no money, and so the man doesn't have so much money to buy and care for the lady, you know, it becomes an issue. But you know, all of those things, some people's issues beyond finances, some are just emotional issues that if you actually know the best approach to it, you wouldn't actually fall into such pit holes. And so that's why we have two beautiful young ladies. Well, apologies to the men, you know, they're actually male coaches, but you know, we could only get females right here in the studio. But of course, I know they wouldn't be biased because they're professionals and they know what they do, and they are so good at what they do, basically. And so I'll start by introducing the very beautiful lady very close to me here. Her name is Jacqueline Oludimu. She's a relationship coach. Good to have you around.
Thank you for having me.
Yes, and she's actually not very new. She's a friend of the station, Nikki Adetoko, relationship coach or relationship consultant too. Good to have you, Nike.
Thank you.
Welcome. And you look beautiful.
Thank you. You too.
Yeah, thank you so very much. So now straight to the discussion, relationship matters, things we do for love. You know, last week we actually discussed something relating to succeeding in marriage. But you know, marriage is the end product of what people in relationship actually fall out to. You know, if it works, they marry. If it don't work, they go their separate ways. But you know, some people have issues in their marriages, and if counselors were to advise them, they would say because they actually missed out some things, or they didn't do some things rightly when they were courting or when they were dating. And so the question is, what are the things that some signs that one would see in a relationship, and you know, that tells you that, oh, if this ends up in marriage, it means I'm in big trouble, or I shouldn't even venture marrying this person, or you know, I'm in this relationship, I like this person, but you know, I'm just doing things right, like the person is not even seeing me as a marriageable prospect, you know. So all those things that, so relationship basically, so tips, if I to make it simpler. So I start with Jacqueline. You know, for you have something that I want to transcend into marriage, but you know, you're at a crossroad, you know, should I marry or should I not? So what are the things that I should look out for to know, oh, this person is a marriageable person, you know, something like that.
Okay, personally for me, and thank you again for having me, personally for me, I always tell my singles, what's the why? Why are you dating who you're dating? So I think that for starters, if you don't have the major reason why you're dating who you're dating, you should not even be thinking about marriage. So if you're considering marriage, then it means that you have defined the reason both of you are together, the reason you want to spend the rest of your life with that person. Now when you have discovered that, then you can have a long list, because what you have access to do today is really a long list. I'm sure Nika will agree, because you have to think about things like love and respect. Mm. Think about how compatible you guys are together, and a lot of things, you know. So first things first, does he respect you? Does he love you? Does she respect you? Because those things are very critical, you know. So both of you, where do you stand? What goal do you have in life? Both of you, even as you date, Are you growing together? So before you even think of marriage, are you growing in your relationship? Are you chasing the same goals? Or if you're not chasing the same goals, at least are you meeting yourself somewhere? It's very important, because a lot of reasons why marriages break is because you realize when you're into it that both of you are going two separate ways. So you must be able to sort of chart your path somewhere where you both are going the same way. If not, there's going to be conflict.
Okay.
You know, so even financially, do you have same financial goals? Spiritually, do you have same, you know, spiritual goals? Career-wise, you know, I always say to my singles, the reason why you would date A, B, C, D, and finally realize that F is the right man or woman is because you never really understood what exactly you were looking for or who you are personally. Because who you are determines who you will be with. Who you are determines who you want to end up your life with, you know. So I feel like those couple of things, you know, I think I've said, I'll let Nika also share a couple of things that, you know.
Okay, for me, I'm going to look at it in two aspects, mindset and patterns. When I mean mindset, a lot of people have mindset about relationship. And I guess there was this argument on Facebook 2 days ago where someone was saying that when you get married, the woman is supposed to just do the domestic chores. Why the men are supposed to go out there and make the money? Why should a woman be making money? Women don't even make money. They're just like slaves, just domestic stuff. Now, this kind of person, when he gets married, he's going to look at his wife in a different way. Right. He's not going to see her as a helper. He's going to see himself like this authority, like this champion, this authority person that can just rule his wife anyhow. Mm-hmm. So many people have different mindset, and that mindset has been as a result of the way they grew up, their upbringing, their environment and experience. It has formed a perception about something. So if you have the wrong perception about a thing that you're going into, it's not going to help you. So until you have a deliverance, I call it deliverance. So when I have my 5-step processes, the first thing I do is relationship mindset shifts. I take you through different questions to notice if you actually know why a relationship is meant to be a relationship, not just because you want to have sex. You need someone that can attend to your chores. You need someone that can just be there. I think we need people that can just go for a robot and not a partner. People need to understand the differences. Someone needs a maid and goes for a wife.
Mm-hmm.
So this mindset has to be cleared. And the second thing is what I call patterns. Patterns are what you keep observing from people, especially your parents. And you've taken this thing as part of your lifestyle. You take it into a relationship. You see your parents get angry at each other. You do not like that anger, but you begin to do it. And you even argue that you don't do it. You see your mom nag over everything. Mom, you nag too much, but you end up nagging. You think it's because you don't like it, but you've learned it unconsciously. So all these patterns that we just take along with us into marriage and baggage, you just take everything into marriage. At the end of the day, you just notice that all the expectations you had just crumbled.
Okay.
And then people have too many expectations. They just see their partner as a god. The partner has to be like a security guard for them. Everything has to be okay. You're going in for marriage for completeness. You're going into marriage because you want to be happy. All those reasons and mindset and perception will definitely crush you.
Okay. Now, so what happens when a young lady and a man get into a relationship and, you know, deep down into the relationship, you know, they are wondering if that is the same person they said yes to.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, they keep saying some things and they're like, okay, this is new, but probably it's just because of his mood or something. And, you know, you keep taking those things, or economy, and you keep taking those things. And so at what point do you say, no, I don't think I want to take this anymore, or I think you need help. You know, I love you, but I think you should get some help if we're eventually going to get married.
Okay. Sincerely, as soon as you notice them, we call those things the red flags. As soon as you spot a red flag, the best thing is to begin to deal with it there and then. Don't defer it. You know, I've always said to singles and even couples when I speak to them, I say to them, anytime you defer a red flag, you're deferring your heartbreak or your issues. So deal with it there and then. So I feel like when you discover that there's something you can't go on with, something that doesn't agree with you, something you can't live with, deal with it there and then. I always say, let's have a relationship talk. You know, let's have a talk about, why is this happening? Why are you doing this? What can we do about it? Okay, maybe we need to seek help. Maybe we need to seek counsel. And that's why, you know, I and Nikki and a couple of other people who are doing great things with singles are there. Because in all fairness, marriage is meant to be enjoyed. It's meant to bring out the best in you.
Yeah.
Because it's a union of two people. So it means that if I could do so much as a single person, when I come together with someone else, then we should do greater things. And so if you cannot identify these red flags and deal with them there and then you're going to have major issues. So there and then, deal with them. Deal with the red flag. Discuss them. And are you sure you can progress? No sentiments when it comes to marriage. no sentiment. So can you really live with this behavior, this pattern of, you know, like Nick said, that has all of a sudden come into view now that we're dating and really considering long term? Can you? And if you cannot, then yes, let's deal with this. There are many ways to do that.
Okay, now there's an issue of past. You know, you're dating someone who is married before, but you know, you discover that you couldn't live with the lady anymore and he has two children. And you're marrying him, saying, oh, he's starting on a good note, and so because I love him, you know, I'm going to forget his past. And in marriage, he comes up with some attitude that you're quite shocked at. So was it a mistake for you to actually do away with the past and move on with the person in the future?
Okay, I think there is nothing like irreconcilable differences. People don't just want to come down and settle things. When you look at all these issues, if you really sit down, even if you're going to spend weeks and months settling it, you can definitely settle these things. Now, when someone hasn't been able to make the first marriage work, you need to understand that there are different reasons. So someone was talking to me that she wants to get married to a particular man, and I asked, okay, is he a married man or single? She said, oh, he's a married man, but he has left his wives.
When wives.
I heard wives, I said, okay, how many wives are we talking about? She said, like three wives. She's going to be the fourth. Now, this woman is 43, so she's kind of desperate. So I'm like, what makes you think the marriage is going to work with you? Is it not better for you to just be single? Because you want to get married to someone who cannot make, he has not made those three work, and you want him to make your own work. So I guess one of the mistakes we make is we live in self-denial. You live in self-denial. You know that something is wrong, but you just refuse to admit it. The minute you refuse to admit a problem, you're not going to be able to move past it. You might think you've actually gone behind that, but it always haunts you. So you need to be able to sit down. It's just like you're trying to make money. You want to make 1 million, but you have this millionaire mindset block. You always tell yourself, it's not possible. Well, nobody in my house has ever made it to a millionaire. But someone, your coach is telling you, you can make it. If you do not settle it in your mind, it will not come to reality. So when you get married and you forget your past, you think your past is just the past. No. Those things can come back to haunt you. So you need to settle every single thing that is involving your past.
So how can one settle? How can one settle? Before you answer the question, let's just open the phone lines. If you want to be a part of this conversation, feel free to dial the number shown on your screen. If you have issues in your relationship, questions, or issues you'd like them to help you solve, please call the number shown on your screen, and they would be glad to answer all of those questions you have. So,
okay, the first thing that you need to do is to come to a realization that something is wrong. That's the first thing. You need to admit. So if you're going through addiction, if you don't admit that something is wrong, you cannot come out of it. So when you tell yourself, okay, I have issues with anger, I have issues with jealousy, I have issues with this, okay, it is true, this is what is wrong with me. At that point, it becomes easier for whoever wants to help you. Now, when you're done with that, you need to ask yourself, is this something I can solve on my own, or something that I need an accountable partner? Now, one of the mistakes we make is we look at the church or pastors as the solution to every relationship problem. A pastor is not a finance coach, it's not a business coach, it's not a relationship coach, it's only a spiritual thing. Fine, he can use his wisdom to help you, but there are some questions that deal with psychology that you need to understand very well. So the fact that you came to me and you told me you have a problem, I can't just give you surface issues. I mean, that's the reason why people, especially in Nigeria, we find it difficult to invest in relationship therapies. Because we think that we see a lot of news on Google, you see different people talking about relationships, so I can just pick up this knowledge and work on it. But it doesn't work that way, because you're unique. Everybody is a unique person.
Okay.
Now, the reason for your problem can be different from our own, even if it's the same output I'm seeing. So both of you have issues with one thing, I can see it, but there are different sources. So at this point, you need to either go and talk to a therapist, a coach, or you want to talk to your partner about it, depending on how responsible your partner is, or you want to help yourself. There are three ways to it. Or you want to fall, maybe how you can get it online or something. Then you need to go back to your past. You need to drive down back into your past. Where exactly did this problem come from? Is there something that has happened? Is there a word I listened to and I accepted in my mind? Is there something I saw when I was growing up and I accepted it? And the thing is, we are used to Nollywood, African magic. Now, when you keep watching different kind of movies, telemundos, novels, you keep seeing ideas of marriages and you think that's how it's always going to be. Happy ever after landing. Who says so? It's like a continuous, you have to continue doing it. If you're not intentional, the 1 week that you refuse to be intentional can cause a 1 year of problem.
Okay.
So you need to be able to go into your past and find out the source. Now, when you're able to do this, you now have to ask yourself, how do I move from where I am to where I want to be? Do I need to go and talk to a person that's going to help me? If you have to pay for it, please do. Do not just expect a free counsel every now and then. When they ask you to do something, please do it. They can ask you questions, reveal it. A woman came to meet me that her marriage is about to crash. And to her, it was just her husband's problem. But when I was done with her, I went into her family, her grandmom. Anger issues, different issues. And I saw it even in her own daughter. Now, to her, she wasn't expecting that. She was just crying on the phone, like, how come all these issues relate to my current problem? I said, those things have developed over time. So you're denying them, but they're actually ruining your marriage. And after a while, thank God she cooperated. After like 2 weeks, her marriage is back. She's finally back in Nigeria to meet her husband. And that was because she cooperated. So some people don't want to cooperate. You tell them to do something, it's a lie. They want 5 minutes sharp work. It doesn't work. So you want to go and meet one abadis that will give you concussion and will make it work. It doesn't work like that. It has to be intentional. Okay. It might take time. Yeah.
Okay, now for someone who has gone through a series of heartbreak, you know, you went one marriage, you realized that the husband jilted you. And, you know, you decided that, okay, you were not going to get crumbled. You were going to give another marriage a shot.
Okay.
And so the same mistake the first husband made, which is infidelity, was made by the second husband. And so you are all just broken. And the only response you could give is, I don't think it's possible for me to heal. Or probably I'll not just marry someone in Nigeria. Probably I'll try a white man. You know, probably white men are more faithful and the rest, you know. But someone with that kind of issue, is there anything like impossible to heal for such a person?
There's nothing like that. And really, I wanted to add to what Nika was saying about the past. And I wanted to say that, you see, before, when you have to deal with the past, please deal with it. Because even if you break up or you end that relationship, before you move on to the next one, it's important that you have put the past, you have dealt with it, you have learned from the past. So like she said also, maybe there was something wrong with you or with your choice. And that's the same thing with the lady, I mean, the example you've just given to us now. So maybe she didn't take her time to decide, okay, so what was that thing, you know, that made me leave that man? What was wrong with the man? Because you need to identify the problem. You need to also be ready to look out for it not happening the second one. And you say, I go back again to the why. So why did you move on to the next person? Maybe out of loneliness, maybe, you know, you need help financially or whatsoever. Because if you do not deal with the reason you're moving on, then the same thing will keep happening over and over again. And that's why, like I said earlier on, you see ladies move or guys move from one girl to another because they haven't gotten it right. There's nothing like you cannot heal. You can heal. But I think you have to be smarter. The best thing that happens to anyone who's gone through a heartbreak is to learn from that heartbreak so that it doesn't happen again.
Okay.
And there again, we go back to intentional dating, intentional choice making. You don't just make it just because you feel like it.
How about you decided to marry this new person because he was a whole lot sweeter and, you know, he didn't have traits of the first husband who was drinking and liked a lot of ladies. But, you know, the second husband didn't so much like ladies. But you were just shocked to find out that you caught him sleeping with somebody and you didn't see all the traits when you decided to marry him. And so you're wondering, like, is this how I'm going to continue with my life? Or I better just cancel something called marriage and just stay alone all the rest of my life?
I'm sure Nika will agree with me that sometimes it may even now be the woman who has a problem, who is making them go and cheat. I don't know if you get what I mean. Nika, I mean, if you agree with me, sometimes we realize in the course of our work, we realize that sometimes someone may not have he may not show you the traits. Now, either because he's keeping it or because, you know, he's trying to make you come on his side, so fall in love with him, get married to you, and then he now shows you who the real, you know, he is. But sometimes also I realize that ladies or even men do things that trigger off something wrong in another person. So sometimes that's why you have to deal with yourself as well. Check if there's something you're supposed to be doing that you're not doing that sort of all of a sudden. Of course, I'm not trying to approve, but the point is sometimes it may even be you. You know, sometimes it may be that person who has kept it. Like, you know, I'll let Nika add on to this as well. The truth of the matter is there's always that element that you just didn't pay attention to. I always say that there's always that element you didn't pay attention to. And so you should pay attention as much as you can. And like I said before, when you see the red flag, as soon as you see it, take a chill pill. You don't have to hurry into the relationship. But like you said, if she did not see it, I'll let Nika add on to that.
Before moving to the inner part, I would like to say that there's something we call power of projection and attraction.
Mm.
No matter what you do, even when you use the best makeup, the best dress, you always project who you are.
Mm.
If you wake up this morning with a very sad and moody feeling, all through that day, everything that looks sad and moody will come to you because you attracted it to yourself. Now, when you do not work on yourself, just like she mentioned, you keep projecting that part of you. It doesn't happen deliberately, it happens unconsciously. You just begin to do something that brings a particular kind of man to you. Now, when you're the kind of person that takes time to even have deep communication, I call it open communication, you can easily get on someone who is pretending like you. These days, people want to put their best foot forward. So you pretend from your house, you package yourself very well, you're going out there to look for a relationship. Another person has also packaged himself. Both of you jam, you meet each other. Both of you are actually pretending, and then later on, it gets open. Why? Because both of you are the same kind of person. Now, the issue is, they could be cheating because she's actually doing something that is attracting them. Now, when you are able to build yourself, you're able to work on yourself, and you're able to heal, along the line, you have to actually break, just like you said, she's mentioned, you have to take your time.
Yeah.
You do not rush. People are scared of being lonely. That's the point. You know, when I had a very major outbreak, I wondered, like, is there something going to happen again? And for like a year, I was alone, and that was one of my best times.
Yes.
That was the first time I actually felt like, wow, so I could really enjoy myself like this. Now, when it comes to healing, she can heal. She will definitely heal. It's just that it doesn't happen in just 1 minute. I'm going to be releasing a book very soon, which is Do It Yourself, a step-by-step guide on how to overcome outbreaks. Like, I can tell you that even when you read that book yourself and you take time to actually implement those principles, it's going to help you along the line. The problem we have is we always feel overwhelmed with issues that we don't take our time to really sit down, and we don't find a way to pour it out. You need to be able to vent out. If you have to shout somewhere, if you have to write it down in a diary,
you have to cry, do that.
But when you're done with that, make sure that you find something that can occupy that space.
Let's take this first caller.
Okay.
Hello, good to have you. We just lost the call. Please feel free to call back just before we wrap up with this segment. And so you talked about healing and, you know, doing everything possible to ensure that you're totally free of that thing. But, you know, from the trait of our discussion, probably because we are ladies, you know, we've tilted more to the ladies, you know, but on the side of the men, you know, a man will say that men too go through a lot just because they don't say it out, or they don't easily talk and complain like the ladies do. Oh, he doesn't care for me. You know, you hardly find a guy complain. You know, they just want to be the man and bottle it up and the rest. And so for a man who is actually having issues with someone he really likes, and, you know, he just doesn't know how to express that thing, and he plans to marry the person, but just because of that trait he's seeing, you know, there's no way to communicate what he feels. You know, how can such a man help himself and help his relationship?
Okay, the first thing is, there's this notion that men are strong and men should not cry, and that has really affected a lot of men. So men grow up, the more, even while they're still like 4 years old, maybe another child beats up the boy, and they're like, "Don't, come on, don't cry, he's the big boy." And that is the way they grow up, feeling like it's wrong to actually express. And because men are more like a silent personality, unlike women, we are expressive.
Yeah.
So men actually find it, because they could actually sit down somewhere alone for 1 hour thinking about the whole thing while you are somewhere for 1 hour shouting about That's the difference between men and women. You understand? Yeah. So I think that sometimes men need to really come to the fact that they are women. There is just no point trying to cover up things. And 80% of people who seek for relationship help are actually women, because men think that there's no problem with them. And then a man thinks that, well, I can get over this. So he goes out there to drink, to play with his friends, and then he goes on to another relationship and repeat the same pattern. So the only advice I would say is speak up. Nothing is wrong with you when you speak up. Okay. I actually appreciate men that come out and talk.
Okay, let's take Emeka. Interestingly, we have Emeka calling. Emeka, good to have you join us. Go ahead, please.
Thank you very much. Good day, ladies.
Good day.
Hello, Emeka.
Good day, ladies.
Hello, Emeka.
Yeah, please, my name is Emeka. I'm calling from Warri. Yes, I enjoy your topic this morning.
Thank you.
It is true. The men try to hide their feelings. But people like me, I don't like hiding my own feelings. I've had a series of heartbreaks, very serious ones, of which the thing is even threatening my life now. I am not all that complete now. I don't know whether it's my fault or the people that I meet that are the problem. I would like our guest on TV there to please help me. I need cancer. I don't know how I can get the cancer.
Okay.
Please, from them, yes. If they can't give me the address, I wouldn't mind coming for it, please. I'm really in pain.
All right. Thank you very much, Emeka, for joining us on the program. And I hope they can help you with the little they can. But if you want their contact, probably you call at the end of the program to keep in touch with them to get proper counsel on what you're really going through. So do you have anything for Emeka?
Well,
series of heartbreaks?
Yeah, I think, like I said the first time, most of the time we forget to work on ourselves, but we want to go for relationships. So just like education, you cannot just come out of primary four and say you want to go to university. Mm. It's not going to work. So we always have a way of living the proper stages of our lives. And to some extent, when you do not find a meaning of your life, because the essence of us being on this earth is to find purpose and serve humanity, work in that aspect.
Okay.
When you don't feel that gap and you begin to use relationships to fill that gap, something is always going to happen. So I'm happy that Emeka wants to find help.
Okay.
So maybe we're going to find a way of doing that for him.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, very quickly now, before we wrap up the program, you know, recently I've been seeing a lot of hard love on news mediums. You know, I saw a guy who said he was dating someone who her husband has died, and her husband divorced her, so he was dating the lady has three children, and he said he would be the one to buy the lady phone, but each time he asked for sex the lady denies him, but he thought they were in a relationship so all of a sudden the lady just told him off and said, oh, she's not interested again. And all the guy did in name of love was he went to the house where she was living when they were sleeping. He burnt the house where she and her three children and her mother was. And so it's, you know, how do you identify someone who has a mental problem? Do you understand? And you think you are in a love relationship, or, you know, you do something very little and it sparks up and you're wondering what he can do. Someone who turns into a serial killer because in the name of he loves you. So how can you identify people who has issues and, you know, you're just trying to break off from them and you don't want to die? You get.
Okay. Let's assume that she's not at fault right now. Let's cover our own aspect because
okay.
We're looking at the man. I think that everybody always show off their part of them in a little way. For instance, there are different ways of abusing people. It could be physically, it could be emotionally, and the like.
It could be verbal.
Now, it could be verbally. So, for someone who always says, I will slap you.
No, this guy is very sweet.
He's very sweet.
He's very sweet, he's very loving, but you're shocked that the moment you say, you know, I'm not interested in this relationship again, it becomes an issue.
An issue.
It becomes like a do or die kind of
are
love.
Are you sure he has not been showing some... Are you sure that he has never... Like
it's never been abusive. It's never been.
There's never been abusive.
Yes.
Okay. Another thing is this: you see, every single woman on earth have this aura of wickedness, except one who pretend. Thank God for Christ. Now, if you allow something to trigger that aspect, now when you look at it, she's definitely asking for everything, but she doesn't want to give sex.
Yeah.
Now that's the problem women are having. When you make a man your breadwinner. And you know that this man would want something in return, then you're looking for trouble.
Mm.
So I don't want to say he's at fault, but he went too far.
Yeah.
Now at that point, she broke up with him. He went to sit down and he's like,
he
need to do something.
Do something.
Now when there is anger in you, it starts with an offense. When you don't handle the offense very well, it moves to anger. When you don't handle the anger very well, it moves to murder.
Mm.
That's what happens. That's the process. You understand? So this little thread of these offenses keep thickening until it leads you to do what you don't want.
He
must have sat down either with his friends who advised him or just by himself, and the thought came to him, you have to show this girl that you have what it takes. Now by the time he's done with the old killing, he's still not himself until he's done. That's when he's like, what have I done? That's when you notice that this guy actually has a problem before.
Can I quickly
okay,
mention,
very quickly,
and
please,
can I advise
to...
singles, please look out for traits of obsession. It's very important, you know. A man is not just going to burn a house and burn, you know, your kids and all you have, or, you know, property just like that. Look out for traits of obsession. Don't take obsession for true love.
Mm.
Don't get it twisted. Okay, so also, one of the things I also think that the lady should have noticed is how he treats people. So, you know, a lot of us, when we're dating, we pay attention to all the love that the man or the lady shows us. Watch out for how he treats the waiter, the bus driver, you know, the gate man, you know, just watch out for those behaviors, those traits, because they will come out. Mm. They will come out eventually. So just please don't mistake obsession for love. Watch out for those abusive traits, those traits that show that he may be very violent, he may be very wicked. Mm. Please watch out for those traits.
All right,
please.
Thank you so very much. That was just so enlightening, Jacqueline Oludemo and Nikki Adetokun. It was so lovely having you. And keep doing what you're doing, because you're really doing really great to what you're doing, and I'm so proud of you. I'm proud to be a lady. All right, so we want to wrap up this segment, the topic relationship matters, things we do for love, and I hope you are well enlightened with what they brought to you today. And so the program isn't over yet, because we still have another segment, which is the entertainment segment. Who will be joining us? An up and coming artist who will be joining us in the studio very quickly. So stay with us and we'll be back with more.
You can now watch Core TV News live from anywhere in the world on our website, www.coretvnews.com. Click on Live TV on our website and watch us live.
And welcome to Core TV Primetime News.
To follow us on Twitter, click on Twitter icon on our website. And Facebook, click on the Facebook and YouTube to see all our previous news production. You can also watch us live on YouTube. Click Core TV. Leave a space, then news. Core TV News, a 24-hour news station.